Hi everyone, today I have some makeup slash beauty and hair do's and don'ts for you, and this is going to be a video and there's going to be 10 tips, do's and don'ts. So I guess I'll start off with the do's and then go to the don'ts, or should I alternate? I think I'll alternate. Alright, so first the do. Do store your paint pots upside down or any cream bases that you have, because these bases, they harden very quickly. Not only just MAC ones, but any cream bases that you have will harden. So store them upside down so that the moisture that's in them can sink to the top so that it doesn't start cracking around the edges as easily. So that's one little tip for you in your storage. If you can store them upside down, that would be a better choice. Alright, a don't that I think some people don't know, and it annoys me so much, because you could save, you know, a lot of precious mascara if you don't pump your mascara. So when you get your mascara out of the wand, don't go like that and pump it up and down. What you want to do is just twist it, because when you twist it, you're not letting as much air into the container, and the air dries it out, really dries it out. And also when you twist it, there's less clumps on the wand, because if you pump, there'll be lots of clumps. So always twist instead of pumping. The next do is do apply eyeshadows wet if you want to have a better color payoff. Now all the time, this doesn't really work. Applying wet colors in the crease, for instance, isn't a good way to go because they won't blend as easily. But if you're doing a lid color and you want the full color potential, you want very high pigmentation on a product, on an eyeshadow, then use a mixing medium or just water. This is Max Fix Plus. You can spray it on your brush and then put the eyeshadow on your eye and it'll really intensify the color. I remember I was like amazed when I first found that out. So that's definitely something you can do. And like I said, you could just use water if you don't have a mixing medium. Next, don't brush your hair when it's wet. You can comb your hair instead. I know that's weird because you normally might have like knots when it's wet, but you're not supposed to brush your wet hair because it's said to damage it more that way, because you're really yanking on it and it's not necessarily the healthiest way to approach your hair when it's wet. So try to use a comb and just brush through it. If you can't get a knot out, then no big deal. Just wait till it dries and then you can try to figure that out, because your hair is really fragile when it's wet. You don't want to be yanking it with a really big brush when it's wet. Here's another hair one. Do rinse your hair with ice cold water right when you're about to get out of the shower. This will really help with the shine of your hair, because if you're in the shower and you like hot showers like I do, I love hot showers. One thing, your hair is going to be really just mad at you, because it's going to be like, stop killing me, I'm dying here. Even though it feels good for you, it doesn't feel good for your hair. So right when you're going to get out, just try turning the faucet all the way to the coldest thing and just bear it out for like 5 seconds and just rinse your hair with that cold water. It'll make your hair a little shinier and it'll also just give your hair a little breath so that it can take a breather from all the hot steam. Next, don't tug on your eye when you're putting on gel liner on your upper lash line. And I know I had a lot of trouble with this when I first started out, because it's so hard not to, because when you hold your eye, it's a lot easier to line. But if you can practice, just keep practicing and try it to see if you can line your upper lash line without pulling like that, because you'll start seeing premature wrinkles. And I'm not saying you'll see them overnight, but in time, you will notice that you'll get some wrinkles that you probably wouldn't have gotten if you didn't yank. So I know it takes practice, but you will get it in time. Next, do wash your hands before every time you do your makeup, because you have so many germs on these hands, you don't even know. So just give them a quick rinse with some hot water and soap before you do your makeup so that all those germs that are on your hands aren't going onto your face. And I'm sure you guys knew that one, but some people still, you know, don't do it. You could always use a hand sanitizer or something like that, a wipe really quickly before you do your makeup. Now, this is another hair one. Don't use heat every day on your hair. Yes, you can. I mean, obviously you can. It's up to you. But I recommend not doing that, because your hair will get very damaged very quickly if you do that. Try scrunching your hair one day like I did today. Or just leaving it down and putting it in a ponytail. So just try something new that doesn't involve heat so you don't end up with really damaged hair and really damaged ends. Now, this last one is do apply moisturizer every single night before you go to bed. And moisturizer is so important because it keeps your face looking so radiant. If you cleanse your face before bed and you don't put moisturizer on, especially for those of you who have dry skin, you're going to see that your skin's getting flaky. It's not looking as even in complexion. But if you put moisturizer on every night, then you will have really glowing skin, and I guarantee it. I use my Clinique moisturizer every night, and I really have seen differences between when I don't use it and when I do use it. So my skin just looks a little more glowy when I do. So that's the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this very much. If you have any tips for me and for your other people in the YouTube community, then just leave them in the comments below. I would love to read them and get some tips for myself, and also everyone else can see them. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll talk to you later. Bye, guys.